Simplify the complex fraction. Problem number three. We are going to use the method of clearing the fractions. And to do that, we need to first find the least common denominator. To find the least common denominator, we can list all individual denominators. And in this case, we have n squared, n, and n squared. So n and n squared. When we have variables, we always choose the variable with the highest degree. In this case, it's 2. So our least common denominator would be n squared. Now we have to multiply each individual term by that least common denominator to clear the fractions. 1 over n plus 9 over n squared. And multiplying by n squared, we see what will happen. So when we are multiplying by n squared up here, nothing really cancels out. But over here, we have n squared in the bottom, n squared on top. It will cancel out. And then over here, n in the bottom, n squared on top. So one of them is going away. And then n squared and n squared cancels each other out. Multiplying what's left over, we get n squared times 1, n squared, and then minus just 81, everything canceled out. Over here, 1 n is left times 1, so n plus, and then only 9 left. This looks like the difference of two perfect squares. So I have to go a step further to use factoring and then check if I could simplify any further. So factoring by using the difference of two perfect squares, we have to square root the first term, n and n, square root the 81, which gives me 9, 9, and then I need a minus and a plus. And now I have n plus 9 in the bottom, and n plus 9 cancels out. So the only thing I'm left with is n minus 9, which is my final answer for this particular problem.